Ayo, I am the star in any room that I stand in. I am the standout, you just my stand-in. These bitches copy my homework, that's what they hand in. That's why I'm private like the airports I land in. Life is a beach house, don't let the sand in. I ball in any arena, go let the fans in. I should go cop a New Jersey, that's where the Camden. These bitches time tick-tocking, better stick to dancing. DNG the wallet, my money tall and brolic. Big ass backyards just so Papa Bear could frolic. With margarita pizza, with Parmesan and garlic. These bitches thirsty, I can see why they alcoholics. Ain't gotta ever talk about it when you are about it. Just bought a new car, not to drive it, but to walk around it. Just call me Nicki, cop the blicky, the Minaj is silent. Brand new vanilla Maserati, I've been Haagen-Dazing. He call me solid, even though I'm dripping water diet. Big booty sticking out my Daisy Dukes to cause a riot. These bitches.
Peace, 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 family. How you all doing? My name is Keisha. I'm the owner of Ascendant Astrology, and I am your astrology coach. Today, we are going to be discussing Chiron conjunct the North Node happening February 2024. Now, I already know you guys are thinking, why is she doing a video that's not until next year? Because the North Node officially being in Aries is going to bring up a lot of these themes. And so when we get to that point and we do another video talking about what can be coming up with you, a lot of this stuff is going to make a lot more sense. You can keep it in the back of your mind. But know in the process, everything that's happening now up until that point is going to grow. You might change and transform in different kind of ways. They might become more clearer or more like a light will shine on it more, like more direct. Either way, however it's going to be showing up for you, these are going to be very real themes that we'll be working through during that time. But starting now, especially even having planets in Leo and Aries kind of have the same energy, if you will. During Leo season, we'll have trines to Chiron. This is activating themes of self-wounds. And Venus retrograde in Leo is giving us opportunities to go deeper, to send these wounds deeper into these wounds so that we can get to the root cause of the self, why we are who we are, who we are, what we're here for, and much more. On August 12th to the 16th, 2023 is going to be a powerful opportunity for healing. And that's going to be right at the Leo new moon, which is going to kind of kick up dust around a lot of these themes. And so Chiron, which, by the way, before I jump into that, I did do a video on Chiron and Aries, probably on my old page, because Chiron's been in Aries since 2018. And so I went through, I did the whole history, the storyline, the mythology behind it, what we were seeing back in that time in greater detail. I'm not doing that in this video. It's kind of like just a refresher, a reminder, just to get everybody thinking about how this is going to be playing out for you. So Chiron has been in Aries since the spring of 2018, and it'll be there till the spring of 2027. Health is going to be a huge theme for this transit, because Chiron is the centaur, and also known as the wounded healer. And the story of Chiron is that he was in battle for years, a long, long battle. And he got hurt really, really bad. He can heal others, but he couldn't heal himself. And he went through that pain for hundreds and thousands of years just dealing with it. But because he was immortal, he couldn't, he'd have to live with that pain forever. He finally got the courage to ask the gods if they could heal him or make him mortal so that he could heal. And once he did that, he was able to give back. You know, he had gained so much wisdom from going through so much pain that he was able to give back what he learned through that journey, how to deal with pain, how to heal pain, and things of that nature. And so Chiron in our chart shows us where these really deep, long wounds are, how we can transform and change and grow from them, and then teach others how to get through similar situations. So that might be a repeated theme as I go through this, but that's the gist of what Chiron is in your chart. I also did a video, which I might post on IG, Chiron through the signs, so that you can know where Chiron is in your chart, because it'll be different for everybody. Like mine's is in Taurus and the eighth house. And so you want to know where yours is as well. So I'll do some posts on that, as well as horoscopes closer to the date of this transit. So Chiron represents personal growth and healing. Chiron is the area of life where we can carry emotional wounds, insecurity, and trauma. It's an opportunity to transform your pain and teach others. This could be unconventional wisdom from your own challenges that you can guide others going through similar challenges. I want when I was originally thinking of this energy, I was meditating on my personal story, which I did share with on my website. So if you click the link up above, you go to my website, to my page where it tells all about me. Down the bottom, I put my story and how I came to become an astrologer. I was really thinking about this, like, you know, there's education, right? Like school education, but then there's life as a school, you know, that really teaches you. I feel like school life, school teaching from the learnings and education that you get through life is a lot more important than even education at sometimes, depending on what field you're in and kind of what you do. But I feel like you learn a lot more from the different challenges and things that you go through and experience, right? And I feel like this is what this is going to feel like. You have some kind of wisdom of something that you've been through, very traumatic. It might have seemed like it was for a really long time or over a long period of years. And once you finally get it and learn it and have that breakthrough, you become a teacher. A lot of people will be willing to share their personal stories where they felt like an outsider and personal struggles. We can definitely see more personal coaches, wellness coaches, and encouraging others to help themselves. That's going to be a huge theme. I did talk about that more even in the Aries North Node video. And that's where the similarities become to come in, because Aries is always about the self. We can, this could also go, this is also going to bring up holistic physical, emotional, and spiritual healing. We want to watch from wherever Mars is. And as Mars goes through each transit, it's going to give more information on what we're working through at that time or during this entire transit, really. And when I say this entire transit, I'm specifically speaking about just Chiron being in Aries. And with the long period of time that it's in there, if you paying attention to what Mars is going through any other time, you're also tapped into Chiron and Aries energy, because Aries is ruled by Mars, right? This transit indicates you're going through some kind of transformative journey that can lead to personal growth and healing, and certain phases of healing, like rites of passage that are painful, but they help us grow. You can become a mentor, or this could lead to mentorship, teaching. These will be themes that I think we'll even see in the world, like that there'll be things that people want to do more through having some kind of breakthrough. You can be called to guide others through teaching and mentorship. You can be led on a spiritual journey to understand suffering that led you to study, that might lead you to studying like shamanic practices or to gain the ability to connect to your higher self and receive channeled messages from your higher self or your guides or, you know, however, whatever tradition it is that you're studying. However, those things come through, they're either through your ancestors, guides, or your higher self, which I feel like are pieces of you anyway. But that's just my personal opinion. You can go on spiritual quests. That's going to be another theme that we might see. So people, we might see a lot of people going like on retreats and trying ayahuasca and things of that nature to find their true selves, or doing like what is the name of that? It's a Piscean theme. It's still making me mad that I can't think of the names, but that's because I'm not talking about Pisces. This can encourage spiritual health and connection, or having a connection to the divine, your ancestors, more deeply, more intentional. This can lead to you studying Native American traditions. There are other traditions that are like this, even African traditions, like Yoruba. I hope I'm saying that right. There are a bunch of different kinds, but I always think of New Orleans anytime I think of like any kind of shamanic or holistic healing from this perspective. There's a lot of different ones that people could get really, really connected to. You can find out who your spiritual tribe is, which is whatever's calling to you. If you feel yourself wanting to study like a different tradition or a culture or a country, for whatever reason, go with it. Because 9 times out of 10, this is leading you down the path of self-discovery to find your soul tribe, your soul circle, and some kind of spiritual practice that's meant for you to help you get to your higher self, or get to know your higher self on a better level, a deeper level. This is also collective healing. This can bring up deeper need for healing, health, and wellness. I think those themes are going to be massive on the world stage around this time. Encouraging people to do it, seeing other people do it, the importance of doing it. The last time we had this transit was in 2008 in the sign of Aquarius. We've seen an increase in obesity, diabetes, mental health problems. Aquarius is also related to the nervous system, swelling of the legs, hypersensitivity, and the threat of poverty, because it's ruled by Saturn, which is also a Capricorn theme too. Especially because right around that time we had the Great Recession. This is also arthritis and joint pain. Aries will be affected from this the most. This is going to focus on healing wounds around Aries themes like identity, self-worth, finding the courage to find your identity, and independence, can challenge our wounds around creating our identity. Our independence can be undermined or restricted, and we might have to learn to stand on our own 2 feet. I always think of this age between that age between 18, well, some would argue that it's 13 to your like late 20s, but I mean 18 to your late 20s for sure. Where kids do things or they kind of separate, they might find new groups of friends. Not to say you can't be an adult and go through this. Probably happens like right around 40 and up. Where you're just trying, you're changing. Your needs are changing, what you like is changing, your values changing, your worth's changing, because you've learned some things along the way that don't really resonate with people whom you might have been hanging out with in the past. And so it'll happen in all different ways, but a natural split kind of happens from the people that you used to hang with, and you start going on this new journey of self-discovery. I feel like those two ages are like very important, but this could be happening to anybody at any age during this specific time. It just reminds me of the things that we go through. Hope that didn't like mess up the whole video, but I guess I'll have to go back and see. So I'll just keep going here and figure it out later. I'm gonna have to redo it. Yeah, and so you're just sort of kind of finding the things that you like and whatnot. Taking the initiative. There might be challenges around taking risks, or rather, taking the initiative is another theme, but there might be some challenges around taking risks. You might experience setbacks and boldly stepping into your power. You need confidence and bravery to do those things, and it might take a while to build up to say, no, I don't want to do that anymore. I don't like that anymore. It doesn't make me happy anymore. And as we kind of experience those themes, it's like, how are we displaying what we don't like and what we like, which brings up another theme that comes with Aries is anger, confrontation, and conflict resolution skills. These could be people seeing you as being mean for standing up for yourself, being selfish, and people might not be responding well to the boundaries that you're putting up for yourself or putting yourself first. This is going to teach us how to channel our anger in a positive way. I think physical health, energy levels, and self-esteem is another theme that comes up with Aries. We'll be embracing positive body image and physical well-being. I'd be interested to see how that turns out. Leadership and individuality will be another theme that we see come up at this time. We can see issues with leadership roles, feeling undermined in a position of authority, or struggling with the need to express our own individuality. We are recognizing our own unique contributions through healing, which I think is another thing that we kind of low key. What's opposite of Aries is Libra, where we're very passive aggressive. Oh, I don't really want the recognition, or oh no, it's okay. A very passive aggressive, too nice kind of sort of, and not it can almost come off as you don't know your worth, you know. So just learning how to say thank you, I appreciate you when somebody gives you a good compliment, and knowing that you deserve that compliment. Especially as you heal, you know, because you're doing something that you love, that you learn, that you know that you're good at. And you inadvertently learn to know that you deserve a contribution for that, right? I think we can see that playing out a lot more in the healing professions, like astrology, numerology, and things of that nature. I'm not even gonna get into the whole money thing because y'all already know how I feel about that, because it's really not about money though, but you deserve to be paid for what it is you do, however that is, and it doesn't always have to be money, right? But appreciation should go into the hard work that goes into having to give these messages all the time. You know what I mean? A lot of things like that could be coming up for people where they might start demanding it a little more, making their services a little bit more, raising their prices and things of that nature to match the level of wisdom, education, and knowledge that they have to give. A lot of things like that could be coming up. We can people see people suffering because they have less freedom, less security, or their health is bad or health issues. I think we can see government officials out of office for sure because of some kind of health issues or being undermined or some kind of backlash. But it also gives an opportunity for others to stand up into leadership roles. We will learn how to organize the life that we want and be more self-directed. Impulsive and impatient is another theme that can be coming up. So we can see issues with impulsive and lack of patience, where we're learning imbalance with thoughtful consideration and patience. That could be really hard for the right person. But again, it's something that I feel like we learn over time. Again, it still reminds me of how kids want. Like if they ask for something, they expected to get it right there in that moment. They seem very entitled and demand, and then they start having the temper tantrums if they don't get their way. You can see that in yourself as you grow. Like you learn to accept, like, okay, I'm not going to get this from this person. And you're either going to say, okay, well, this whatever relationship can't go any further, or you're gonna go out and get it for yourself. Like however it's happening or however it changes and progresses in your life, you can see that in yourself now, and you'll be reevaluating that quite heavily during this transit for this time, for this transit. I think it's gonna be real deep. Self-discovery. That's a really big theme. We could be going on a journey. We're going to learn to slow down enough to really learn who we are and make major lifestyle changes through studying other cultures, asking ourselves, how do we get here to this fast life, hustle and bustle, always on the go mentality, which I think already kind of started with 2020, to be quite frank. Although I hear a lot of jobs are thinking about making people come in permanently, which is going to be very interesting to see how that works out moving forward. And I did talk about this back when, all this stuff was happening, but now we're starting to see it, come to fruition. And it'll be interesting to see if we keep it as a way to work from home for various reasons, or if they completely just take it out. I think there will be all different forms of it because I know the technology world was doing it anyways prior to 2020 happening. And it's interesting to see that a lot of tech companies are going out of business. Like, what is it? Is it something about working from home that's not working that we could be kind of reevaluating or analyzing at this time to see how we could use it effectively? Because for some people, it works, right? Some people actually need it in order to work, right? Everybody has different life changes or life blockages and purposes for needing it. And it'll be interesting to see if they just completely let it go or if they'll keep it on as a healthy work-life balance type of thing. This could also show us where we fear rejection. For being who we are, that's a real another really big theme with Aries, and learning how to accept that and just go with the people who like you for who you are. Instead of trying to change rules and laws to make people accept you for who you are, but everybody's different. And it's like if you don't like something, go somewhere else. Or better yet, they already have, especially in the workplace, laws and rules and regulations around those things. Leave those things the way that they are. Just know that that's probably not going to be the person you talk to on a regular basis. You don't have to be standoffish. You could at least say hi, but you don't have to be their best friend. And I think there's something to say about that balance between the Aries Libra axis that's going to come up quite interestingly, that we will definitely be addressing around that time, around this time. I actually look forward to seeing what that turns out to be, to be honest with you. But I'm already actually seeing a lot of that happening in my workplace that I think is absolutely hilarious. But again, once you grow, I feel like those things are so small and petty. Not to say that they're not important or shouldn't be discussed or anything like that, but when you get to a certain level of being comfortable with yourself, you really don't give a shit about what other people do. You just know instinctually, well, I'm not going to be rude to that person, but I'm certainly not going to be that person's best friend, right? But you'd be surprised how many people don't know who they are to the point where they feel like they have to change somebody in order to feel good about themselves. And that's an outside thing when really it's internal, right? And so it's not taking accountability for why you think, those making those laws or things being known are important. And it takes away the focus of dealing with yourself, which is all of what the 3D does anyway. It's like an ongoing battle. But it was very interesting to see that being played out. I was just sitting there like, I could care less. But some people had some very interesting things to say too that gave me pause. So I learned a lot. I took some things away from it. But for the most part, this is what this is. As usual, family, I love and appreciate you. I hope you found this information helpful. Peace.